Hey guys, David Kwan here. It's definitely been a long time since I did a video. So here I am. It's already now 2013. And in light of that, I want to kind of take a step back and talk about 2012. Things I did in 2012. What that year meant to me. Because in a way, it was a very interesting year for me. Much more different than any other year since I graduated from college. I graduated college in 2010, and May 2010. So even in the beginning of 2010, I guess I was still concerned with college, finishing my year in college. Then I graduated in May, and 2011, I have this ridiculous student loan debt to pay back, and I have no idea how I'm going to do that. There's a lot of uncertainty in the beginning of 2011. Like, I don't know what I'm going to do, what kind of jobs I'm qualify for, not many, and so a lot of growing pains, a lot of uncertainty in the beginning of those years for a person who up to that point was pretty much only focused on school and things of that nature. Now it's like, welcome to the real world, like, what are you going to do? But 2012 was unique for me in the sense that it began with a lot of stability and a lot of certainty. I already had a job at that point. I was working at a homeless shelter. I was at the bottom of a work hierarchy, but it was still, like, compared to the similar positions in any other organization or any other shelter, it paid relatively high, and I worked enough hours unintentionally most of the time. I did a lot of, like, mandated unintentional overtime hours, but all those hours, you know, ended up giving me, you know, making me stable enough to pay my rent and make my student loan payments every month. So I was in a very good, stable position, and I actually started the year working. My New Year's Day, New Year's Eve, all my holidays, in fact, like, I pretty much spent at the shelter working. So it was interesting to start the year on solid footing. And to have this idea, like, hey, you know, I keep doing this for this amount of time, and, you know, I'm starting to think about applying to grad school, making connections with the people who are above me, the people that I work with, you know, to get good reference letters and good recommendations. So it's that time of the, you know, I began with a lot of optimism, and it was like that for, like, the first half of 2012. I mean, granted, it was not an all easy year, but with the position that I was at, I was actually pretty comfortable with it. In fact, I was uncomfortable with how comfortable I was at, if that makes any sense at all. Because I tend to think that I always need to be on my toes, I need to keep pushing myself to be more ambitious, to keep improving myself to be better. But for, like, the first half of 2012, I was just like, yeah, I like where I'm at right now. I wish I could just keep doing this for as long as I can, till I get to the next step. Like, I don't think I would have minded, that back then, and maybe even so now, I don't think I would have minded if I got stuck with that job position for 3 or 4 more years. That would have been like experience building on my resume, and, you know, I mean, I'm pretty sure, I guess after a certain point, I would have felt a little restless and wanted to have been promoted or something, but it was definitely a job I really, really enjoyed doing. I believed in the job a lot and had fun doing it. That's why, you know. But of course, 2012 doesn't end with me just having that job and just being all good and stuff. In about May, after coming back from vacation, because I took vacation time to be with my parents, they wanted me back home for this, like, religious retreat or meeting or something or the other, something like that. And they were like, it's really important that you come back and experience this stuff. So I was just like, okay, I have vacation time, I'll take it. Since I haven't taken a vacation from my work in a long, long time. And my New Year's resolution for 2012 was actually not to call out sick for work unless I was actually sick. And for the most part, I was able to keep that resolution until, like, March. Someday, like, I think one day in March, I was just like, I don't feel like going to work, so I called out sick. For the most part, I kept that. So I've been like a super workaholic. I took that vacation 2 weeks, or I think it was 3 weeks. Came back, and while I was on vacation, a lot of things changed at the shelter. A lot of policy changes, a lot of rule changes, just a whole bunch of changes. A lot of the changes that I was actually glad for, like some of the things I was hoping for things to change. I can't give really specific examples, because, you know, it's still a lot of the things I would still like to keep confidential. Maybe one day I'll make a video about my experiences at the homeless shelter. But for now, I'll just say that a lot of things changed for the better. And so I came back to work, and it was like things were a lot more easier. And the things that I was really frustrated and didn't quite agree with about the shelter, a lot of that changed. So that was really cool. Perhaps I got too complacent. I don't know. But some of the changes, it took me a little bit to getting used to. My supervisor changed and really loved this new, you know, the supervisor. I respected him a lot, but I think one of the reasons why I was so honest with him, when it came time for me to be not honest, because that would really hurt me, I respected him so much as like a coworker and as my superior that I became naively honest. But that's eventually, I did get fired from my job. I did screw up. And so, what happened was, I'll put it very briefly. There is like zero tolerance for alcohol in the shelter. It makes sense. And I totally agree with it, because it's a shelter that serves clients who are diagnosed with, mental illnesses and or chemical addictions. So it makes total sense. And so one day I came to work after having, some alcohol in my system. Like it was like 5 or 6 hours after I drank with a friend. So I should have called out. So that's where I screwed up. I should have called out, but I came to work thinking, you know, I didn't want to put any of my coworkers, give any of my coworkers a burden. Like, oh, I didn't want them to have work an extra shift because I called out because I drank a little bit. That was my reasoning at the time. Stupid reasoning. Screwed up there. But anyway, I did my shift. I actually did 2 extra hours overtime because the person on the next shift, one of them came in late, so I had to stay, you know, until that person. But yeah, work was fine. Like 2 or 3 days later, I have my regular supervision meeting with my supervisor, and we just talk about how the job's going, things I need to work on, stuff like that. But that day, I guess word went around to him that about something, but he's just like, what happened that day that you came to work? And like I said, by this point, I come to respect and admire the supervisor so much that I just was naively honest. I was just like, yeah, I came to work with alcohol in my system. That's probably that's probably why you got all these, you know, that's probably the word that got around to you, or something like that. He was very disappointed, you know, which is understandable. It is definitely not something proud of that I should have done. But yeah, there's a zero tolerance policy. No matter how much they wanted to keep me on, I don't know if they really wanted to keep me on. But long story short, lost my job and I was jobless again. And I remained jobless for about 3 months. I did have unemployment for about those 3 months because, I don't know, I guess I was lucky, but I did get unemployment for about 3 months before the court decided that I should not be receiving unemployment. But that was really helpful. The amount of hours I worked at the shelter was ridiculous. So the amount of money I saved up in benefits that came back to me in a check was really a lot, enough to help me like just take a good 3 months vacation without having to worry about finding a job. So that was nice. So from like June to like October-ish, September, October, like 3 months, I just, I was looking for jobs. I was, you know, fretting around like unemployed, being restless, but 3 months was a good time I took just fooling around, just being idle, just good relaxing vacation, hanging out with friends and stuff. So that was, I guess, it was the kind of vacation I needed. But it somehow ended up that way. And of course, by the time it's like 3 months later, it's just like, oh shit. Like, I gotta pay my rent. Now I'm just like a desperate job searching, job hunting. And somehow I just thought like I need to get immediately hired for something. And so I called up a canvassing or fundraising company because I know how they work. And so I know that if I get accepted, I'll be interviewed like the very same day or the next day, and then I'll get hired like immediately if they like me. And that's what happened. I ended up canvassing. I was really unsure of how well I was going to do, because I know how they work. It's such an unstable like position if you're not good at it. It's a very performance driven field. So if you're not doing good in like 3 days in a row, you're just let go. It's so performance driven. So I was worried I wouldn't have to find something more stable, but it's still what I'm doing now, albeit in a different capacity. That's a whole other story for 2013. But 2012, I do some canvassing. I become pretty good at it. And then just as I start becoming okay with it, election time. So we're sent to Colorado. We're like, hey, we got to stop what we're doing right now. And we got to get President Obama elected. That's the fundraising company. So we went to Colorado, one of the swing states, and got out for to vote for President Obama. That was probably the most challenging thing for me in year 2012. Year 2011, it would have been Hurricane Irene because of the work that I was doing at the shelter for during that time. But 2012, it was definitely getting out the vote for Obama because this is the first time in my life where I was working on a salary instead of on an hourly basis. So in a way, it was kind of horrible because I felt like the nonprofit company, because it was a different company that was hiring us for to get out the boat and not the same company that I was working for in terms of fundraising. That company is just like, hey, we own you now for every hour, every minute that you're awake. So we work ridiculous hours in Colorado. So surviving that was quite amazing. And that's probably another video right there just talking about my experience in Colorado. But yeah, I came back from that. That experience strengthened me a lot. I became a lot better at canvassing, and I was promoted as a field manager. So the year ended like on a very positive note. I had great Thanksgiving party with my boss and her boyfriend at her apartment. So that was really cool, just sharing this like what is traditionally a family gathering with my coworkers and my supervisors. And so that was quite inspiring. I did get to spend like my Christmas holiday, like you know, the winter holidays with my parents. I took 2 weeks off the last 2 weeks of 2012, and I went to my parents and spent it with them, which was really cool. Just because I haven't seen them in a long time, in that just kind of vacation capacity, because in May of 2012, it was mostly just for that religious thing that they wanted me to go to. And the Christmas holidays of 2012, I just went just to spend time with them. And that was nice. My mom, found work again. So she, you know, because after I graduated from college, my mom kind of quit her job. And so she's been unemployed since. And now she's found a job as a nurse she didn't want to work. So that was not a problem. She kind of retired. I actually was surprised that she found work again. But it's nice, cause she's not too tired out by it. She has a very relaxed schedule and, she wants to support me in whatever capacity. So she has extra income now, which I guess if things don't work out too well for me, that's, you know, she could provide for me in a way. I really appreciate it. I always feel guilty, when my mom helps me out, but I really appreciate her. So 2012, that was my year. Started out stable, had like unintended vacation, although I was restless and kind of just, you know, frustrated a lot of that 3 months vacation. Took a new job that is really unstable unless you perform really well all the time, which surprisingly I have performed quite well. Not great by any means, but quite well enough to be able to become a field manager and actually run the office. Like before I took that 2 weeks holiday vacation at the end of the year, I was actually charged with running the office because my bosses, the two directors, they had to go to Colorado for 10 days for training and for company reasons. So they let me in charge of the office. So I was actually practically a director for 10 days. And that was insane. Just having the keys to the office was quite something. That was another challenge too, because the hours that the directors have to work are pretty crazy. Like, I would get to work at like 9:30 or 10 in the morning, and my work wouldn't end until like 10 at night. So it was like a 12-hour shift, pretty much. So I would get home at midnight, start the whole thing again for 10 days straight. So it's been quite a journey. I have no idea what 2013 is going to be like. It's with my life, it's always been kind of, with anyone's life, it's always just kind of, you know, ups and downs here and there. I'm just surprised that this was the first time ever for me in 2012 for me to have gotten fired. Every other time in my life, something always just happened. It wasn't my total screw up that, you know, let me out. And being fired from a shelter makes it really hard to get back into the job market, because I would interview and be like, oh, what happened with your last job? And I'll be like, well, you know, I really suck at, like, you know, smooth talking out of that. It's like, there was a personal circumstance. And she's like, what do you mean? Like, did you leave or were you let go? And it's like, yeah, I was terminated. So that was kind of like a blacklist to any other type of similar jobs or similar organizations. So getting back into the workforce was really tough, which is why I ended up with a very unstable job field like canvassing. But canvassing, turns out, I'm not so bad at it, and it's actually really something I believe in, and it's really fun. But going forward, you know, I don't know. That's just been 2012. Talking about 2013 is probably going to be another video. But yeah, that's been 2012 for me.